Category 00, Tropical Depression. A tropical depression is the absolute beginning, a cluster of thunderstorms with just enough organization to be called a system. Winds are minimal, around 38 miles per hour or less. It doesn't have an official name and nobody warns you about it on the news. The mechanics are simple. Warm ocean water heats the atmosphere above it. Air rises. If there's any spin to that rising air, wind shear, at the surface or a boundary between wet and dry air, rotation can develop. Thunderstorms organize around that rotation. It's just the first step toward becoming something worse. Tropical depressions produce scattered rainfall and light winds that might knock over trash bins or snap thin branches. Mostly, they just drift over open ocean for a few days and dissipate. But they're wild cards. Sometimes they intensify rapidly. Sometimes they fade away. That uncertainty is what makes them interesting to meteorologists. Category 0, Tropical Storm. A tropical depression strengthens. Winds hit 39 miles per hour and boom, it gets an official name. Suddenly it matters. Suddenly people start paying attention. Tropical storms produce sustained winds that can snap tree branches, topple isolated trees, and down power lines. Rainfall becomes significant. Some areas get 5 to 10 inches. Storm surge reaches 3 to 5 feet above normal tide. That's enough to flood coastal roads and scare people inland who've never seen storm surge before. The atmospheric mechanism tightens. The low pressure becomes more defined. The wind field organizes into spiral bands. The system is no longer chaotic, it's structured. Most tropical storms last 3 to 7 days. They weaken over land or cool water and transition into post-tropical systems. The key distinction is they're legitimate weather events that produce real impacts. They can flood areas and cause wind damage, but they're manageable. People survive them. Communities recover. Category 1, hurricane. When a tropical storm hits 74 miles per hour, it officially becomes a hurricane. That 1 mile per hour difference might not sound like much, but it triggers something entirely different in how winds behave and how buildings respond. Category 1 winds are strong enough to snap thick tree branches, the kind that could put a dent in your car. You'll see shingles torn clean off homes. Windows shatter. Power lines come down everywhere. And when they do, utility crews take days or even a week to restore electricity because the damage is spread out so wide. The storm surge is usually 4 to 5 feet above normal tide level. For most people, that doesn't sound terrifying. But then the Atlantic Ocean starts creeping into neighborhoods that have never seen flooding before. Roads become impossible to drive on. Homes that have been standing solid for 100 years suddenly have salt water pouring through the living room. The thing that gets people is they underestimate it. It's only a 1, they say, not that bad. But those people haven't lived through one, haven't watched their roof get torn apart, haven't spent a week without power in sweltering heat, haven't watched their backyard become a lake. Hurricane Ana formed off Mexico with 75 mile per hour winds and headed straight for Hawaii, where you can't evacuate. Ana hit Oahu, the Big Island, Maui, and Kauai on June 11, 2014. Over 100,000 people lost power. Wave surge pushed 6 to 8 feet above normal tide. Hurricane Ana caused $745 million in damage and killed 13 people. Category 2, hurricane. Once you jump from 95 to 96 miles per hour, you enter a completely different world. On paper, it's just a small step up, but in reality, the destruction is significantly worse. At these speeds, trees don't just have branches snapped off anymore. Mature trees that have been growing for decades get completely uprooted. Mobile homes get destroyed completely. You can't repair that kind of damage. You need to replace the whole thing. When the power goes out from a Category 2, you're looking at weeks without electricity, not days. The infrastructure damage goes way deeper. More utility poles are down, more transformers are fried, more lines are destroyed. Utility companies literally cannot keep up with the scale of damage. Water systems fail. People go without running water for extended periods. The storm surge climbs to 6 to 8 feet now. Water pushes a mile inland or more in flat terrain. People who live a few blocks back from the beach suddenly think they're safe. They're not. The water doesn't care about your zip code, it just keeps coming. Hurricane Laura crossed the Atlantic before becoming a tropical storm, then a hurricane. When it hit Puerto Rico and the Dominican Republic on August 27, 2020, It was a Category 2 with winds around 105 miles per hour. The Caribbean islands got pounded. Flooding turned catastrophic. Dozens died. But Laura didn't stay a Category 2. It moved into the Gulf of Mexico and intensified rapidly into a Category 4. That Category 2 phase alone killed dozens and caused billions in damage. Laura ended up costing over $13 billion total. Category 3 hurricane. Category 3 is where meteorologists finally call a hurricane major. That's not just a word choice. It's an acknowledgement that everything has fundamentally changed. When you're dealing with 111 to 129 miles per hour winds, the force increases exponentially. It's not twice as powerful as a Category 1. It's far more powerful. A house built to withstand 110 mile per hour winds might survive some damage from a Category 1. The same house hit by Category 3 winds gets devastated. Roofs completely lost. Sections of walls fail. Structural integrity is gone. This isn't shingles anymore. Homes become partially destroyed or completely uninhabitable. Every single large tree snaps or gets uprooted. Downed trees block roads everywhere. It creates isolation where communities can't be reached for 24 to 48 hours. Power is gone. Water is gone. You're talking weeks without electricity. Water treatment facilities are damaged. There's no way to flush toilets or safely cook food. The storm surge reaches 9 to 12 feet above normal tide. That's an ocean surge that penetrates miles inland. That's permanent saltwater contamination of underground aquifers. That's agricultural land destroyed for an entire season. That's homes sitting in moldy, waterlogged disaster zones for months. Hurricane Jean reached Category 3 status with winds at 120 miles per hour and made landfall in central Florida near Port St. Lucie on September 25, 2004. Those 120 mile per hour winds were brutal. Roofs got ripped off homes. Over 3 million people lost power. Restoration took weeks. But before Jean even reached Florida, it had already killed over 3,000 people in Haiti, the Dominican Republic, and Puerto Rico. Total death count exceeded 3,100. Category 4 hurricane. The jump from 129 to 130 miles per hour is where catastrophic really becomes the accurate word. This is where everything changes. The difference between a house that might be repairable and a house that becomes a pile of rubble. When Category 4 winds hit, roofs get removed completely. Entire roof systems gone. Not just shingles, the whole structure over your head. Walls fail. Homes lose their entire shape. It doesn't even look like a house anymore. It looks like whatever destroyed it. Every tree snaps or gets uprooted. Not some. Every one. Downed trees block every road. Utility poles are down everywhere. There's no way for crews to even reach damaged areas for 24 to 48 hours. When they finally do, the scale of damage is so immense that restoration takes months. Power outages lasting weeks, not days. Everything shuts down. No electricity, no water. Sanitation systems fail. Hospitals are damaged and running on backup generators. Food spoils. Temperatures inside homes climb into the 90s and hundreds. Hospitals become overrun with heat exhaustion, severe dehydration, and injuries from debris. The storm surge reaches 13 to 18 feet above normal tide. Entire coastal communities become submerged. Saltwater penetrates miles inland, destroys agricultural infrastructure, contaminates freshwater supplies. Beaches erode away completely. Coastal roads disappear under the water. Some areas take years just to recover. Hurricane Michael formed on October 2, 2018, and underwent explosive intensification. In less than 48 hours, Michael went from tropical storm to Category 4. On October 10, 2018, Michael made landfall in Mexico Beach, Florida, with 150 mile per hour sustained winds. The damage was apocalyptic. Neighborhoods just ceased to exist. Trees were debarked. Utility poles were twisted like pretzels. Over 2.5 million people lost power, waiting months for restoration. Michael killed over 80 people and caused approximately $25 billion in damages. Category 5 hurricane. You're looking at winds that hit 157 miles per hour and keep climbing from there. At this point, you've crossed into absolute destruction. This is where hurricanes aren't just dangerous, they're cataclysmic. When Category 5 arrives, nothing is safe. There's nowhere to hide, no shelter that's strong enough. Buildings don't get damaged, they get obliterated. Roofs don't just get torn off, entire structures collapse. Homes get reduced to rubble. That's not hyperbole, that's literally what happens. Trees don't snap like in weaker hurricanes. They get shattered, completely debarked, uprooted and destroyed completely. Every single one. There are no standing trees left. Nothing to block the wind, nothing to slow down the damage, just complete destruction for miles. Debris becomes lethal. A piece of wood becomes a missile. A piece of metal becomes a ballistic weapon. If you're caught outside, you don't get blown over. You get hit by debris traveling over 100 miles per hour. That's not survivable. Power doesn't just go out. The entire electrical grid gets destroyed. Substations are damaged beyond repair. Poles are snapped everywhere. Lines are down everywhere. Power restoration takes months, in some cases over a year. The storm surge exceeds 18 feet, sometimes 20 to 25 feet. That's water rising 2 to 3 stories high. In flat coastal terrain, surge penetrates 20 to 30 miles inland. Entire coastal communities become completely underwater. Salt water destroys agricultural land, contaminates aquifers, ruins freshwater supplies. The affected areas become uninhabitable for extended periods, weeks, months, sometimes years. There's no electricity, no running water, no gas, no way to cook food, no way to get medical treatment. People leave permanently. Some communities never recover. The population never comes back. Hurricane Dorian reached Category 5 status in early September with sustained winds exceeding 185 miles per hour. It tracked toward the Bahamas but didn't pass quickly. It slowed, nearly stalled. For almost 24 hours, the Bahamas experienced Category 5 winds. The devastation was beyond description. Homes were obliterated. Storm surge pushed 20-plus feet above normal tide. Over 70 people died in the Bahamas, thousands more missing. Total death toll exceeded 200. Total cost exceeded $12 billion across the Atlantic Basin. Years later, parts of the Bahamas still haven't recovered. The next hurricane heading toward you isn't just a number. It's a unique atmospheric phenomenon with its own potential to reshape coastlines and end lives. Respect it. Take it seriously. Because nature doesn't give second chances in these situations.